12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
And on this week's show, first of all, we're going to start off and kick off with the Worker of the Week, Manny Lindenfeld, has brought out through. Wayne, can you tell us about this effect, first of all?
Yes. It's a linking off effect with some rubber bands put onto your finger, and it is proper eye candy, putting the band onto your index finger and visibly watching it jump onto the next finger along. There's a couple of other processes, but the pinnacle is when it jumps from your fingers onto your spectator's finger, even though your fingers are whipped together by another elastic band. It looks impossible.
Yeah, they're kind of linked together, and you've got this great moment where you kind of go bang, and it goes from your finger straight onto the spectator's finger, like Wayne said. And what about the reactions of the guy on the trailer?
I tell you what, if you'd have paid an actor, you wouldn't have got a better reaction, would you? It was like David Blaine's Street Magic special on acid. They went wild.
I think he was on acid.
Yeah. And who would have thought an elastic band
could be amazing? Oh my God, can I see it again? Oh! My goodness. We went out and did some street magic in London a while ago, and we thought we got some good reactions, and then we checked out that dude on the through trailer, and we realised that is what you're aiming for.
That's how you do it.
That's what you're aiming
for.
That's
how you do it.
So it's got quite a few different things. There's five phases in all.
Yeah.
Four phases where you initially make the band go through your own finger. And I've got to say, when I first opened it, I was a little bit disappointed, because when you open it, you basically get the bands and a download link. You don't get a DVD or anything like that. They are the perfect bands, though. They're the Joe Rindflesh bands, which are the perfect bands for it. We had a go with the bands. We played around with it. But both me and you did say, Wayne, if we were going to do it, you'd have to really just be using the same bands that you use all the time for your crazy man's handcuff style routine. And then go into that routine straight afterwards. But four phases going through your own fingers, but then the best one is actually through the spectator's fingers.
That is actually mind-blowing. I can see me doing this. I can sit down, concentrate on it, make up a lovely routine what goes along with the crazy man's and link it all together, no pun intended.
You don't literally do any elastic band routine, do you?
I don't, not when I'm working. I can do crazy man's routines, but I never do it when I'm working. What I think is important to remember with this, though, we're so often we're reviewing things and we're reviewing a trick. Like we'll be reviewing another trick in a bit, right? What's really nice with this, you're not often now new things come to a market. We're actually buying a routine.
It is a routine. Yeah.
There's a series of effects that build up to that big thing. What seems to be brought out in Magic at the minute is that big thing at the end.
Yeah.
Here's your big thing at the end.
Here's your finale.
And then how do we get to it? What's really nice with this is you're getting a routine that has the big guy candy bit at the end.
So the tutorial's over an hour. They've done a great job on the production here. It's incredibly well shot.
It is
you
very
You find
good.
Yourself, as you're watching it, picking up elastic bands, following along. It's something that I think you could get down in a couple of days and then your muscle memory could kick in. The last elastic band effect I learnt was Infinitum, and that took me about 3 days to get it. And that's the elastic band penetration that looks really good with the pre-linked rubber bands. But I think it's going to take you about 2 or 3 days to get that muscle memory right down. And there's even a bonus routine on there, which I really like, with some headphones.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And you're actually using the same effect. You can't do it with the spectator's fingers, but you can actually make the headphones go through your own finger. And once again, it looks great. It's a great project. I thought it was going to be a good project, but actually it's a really great
project. I really do think it's brilliant, actually.
Really well shot, really well produced, and it's a great routine that happens up here. Not something that you perform down here. The finale, when it goes through the fingers, I love the fact that they're looking straight at you as you make it penetrate and go straight through from your finger onto theirs. And when you take off the band that's holding those two fingers together, they're just left in this impossible situation that they cannot reconstruct.
You can't get that back in your head because there's no question. Your finger and their finger are whipped together with an elastic band, and that other band is around your finger, and you're doing this, and it goes over. You just can't. I reckon this is going to get great. I know that we've just about the trailer, but I think I'm going to get great reactions when I do this.
Well, you are. Okay. And
you're going to use it.
You're going to use
it. I am, yeah.
It fits into a new genre of magic that we've not really spoken a lot about on the show, is this, the whole mobile phone generation. You have to now carefully think about what magic you're going to do. Because people will go, every gig now, can I film this? Or they'll pull out a phone and they'll start filming. So you have to be thinking now, they're going to be going home with a souvenir from you. Now, you know that your ambitious card routine and card on the glass might not look great on a camera. This is another one of those things. Great. If you've got a couple of bands around your wrist, when that guy gets his phone out, you can be going right up to the case camera, his phone, again, bam, bam, bam. So when you're on his Facebook later on that day, you've got something that looks really good and works really well.
It's a worker of the week. How much are you going to give it?
You know what? I'm going to give it 93.
93?
Yeah.
Yeah, 92%.
I'm giving it 95%, and it's getting a worker of the week. If you order it from World Magic Shop,
it's great magic.
Midnight on Friday, you get More Banding Around by Russell Leeds. I think he's put some social media videos up recently with his three-ply band routine. Got some incredible stuff, Russell.
Yeah.
And you get that absolutely free. Shipped with your order of through if you order by Midnight on Friday. It's this week's Worker of the Week, Many Lindfields. I always get his second name. It's always tricky to...
Many Lindfields.
It's like Pacific. Right. It's through. It's brilliant. Elastic Band Penetration that looks great on social media. So last week, myself and Wayne filmed the Retro Review, which is actually quite popular.
It was
looking back at some old items, you've got some ideas of things that you want to look back at, things that we've reviewed in the years gone by, back in the day. And sometimes we didn't give them the points that they deserved. Maybe in the future, through will be worth 100% from all of us. I don't know. Certainly, Twilight Angels only got 90% the first time round. Now I'd be marking it like 90, 95, 96% even. Yeah. It is absolutely fantastic.
You have a chance to go out and work stuff like that, and you want to change your mind.
It's something I intend on using all the time. I was doing a festival the other day for Scouts. I was on stage, there was like 700-800 kids in the audience. It was a great event, actually. But they had a live camera there, so I did Twilight Angels. And the gasp from these scouts when the angel vanishes. Yeah. And of course, we went and performed it on the streets of London and got great reactions.
We got brilliant reactions.
It's a fantastic piece of magic. If you haven't seen the Retro Review, go and see
us. Go and have a look at it, yeah.
On the World Magic Shop Facebook page. And we're going to give you a chance now to win Twilight Angels by taking part in a caption competition. Now, I just scrolled through the timeline from last week's show. And I said, let's try and find somewhere where we can, like, screen capture for this caption competition, and both these two went, that's the one, when I stopped at one point. So let's try and keep it clean, shall we?
You can't.
What we'll do, we'll invite you for a caption competition to win Twilight Angels and a Sudoku book test by Scott Creasy and World Magic Shop. One of our finely produced products. You love this, don't you, Wayne?
I do, mate.
It's like a full routine. Yeah. If you see Wayne's lecture dem, you do a whole routine.
Doing one for tomorrow, yeah.
You'll see Wayne doing the Sudoku book test. It really is a fantastic routine, like you were saying about through, not just one trick. And you've got the Twilight Angels. There's that to win. Winner takes all for the best caption for this image that's on the screen right now.
What do you think of that?
So there, if you could caption that. I think we're talking about your driver's awareness course at that point, actually. And that's why I had
really?
My eyes closed. And I was pretending I was asleep like
Don't
you were at the wheel.
Don't give anybody any ideas. What do you think he's saying?
So, caption competition to win Twilight Angels and the Sudoku book test. And have a look back at the Retro Review. It's on the World Magic Shop Facebook timeline.
And next up, by Hugo Venezuela, we have got Medium.
Amazing.
Is amazing. You might have seen
it. What about that epic music?
I tell you what, I remember watching the other day on the telly on YouTube, David Copperfield flying and the dramatic music. This is much more dramatic than that.
Obviously, with the choice of music.
This is like somebody from upstairs, somebody from the gods is going to come down and start talking to you. And with his wisdom, when God is talking to you, he's going to say, with my powers, I'm not going to put the world to good. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to turn a coin over in your hand. And And yeah, and it's a very medium way of doing it. This is the gimmick.
Right, let's talk. Should we talk about the price? Best part of 50 quid.
50 quid, so you're
it's
getting...
Wayne, what do you think to the price? Great value for an epic piece of magic like that, right?
No. That's a lot of money. It's a lot of money
For what it is, and but
no, not for what it is, for the effect.
For the effect.
But there's two. Not for what it is.
There's two things with this. Number one is the gimmick does work, but there's a lot of process and a lot of faffing around to make the gimmick.
A lot of hand washing.
A lot of Michael Vincent would be very good at this, right? you're going to have very clean hands if you're doing this, almost too clean, right? And so that's number one. And the other thing is there are other ways of doing similar effects that are a lot cleaner. And like the Voodoo Doll.
By Rogue.
Yeah.
And I've got a bone to pick with that guy Rogue.
Oh, really?
Yeah. In fact, can we call on the magic police, guys?
Oh no.
Yes, I've got a little bit of a problem with this guy called Rogue because we reviewed his Haunted Doll quite some time ago, and it was a great project. But you know, we were talking about Crazy Man's Handcuffs before.
Mm-hmm.
I was actually at a gig. I was doing Crazy Man's Handcuffs, which has to be a staple of a professional magician's routine.
Oh, and it goes right up to the top. David Copperfield has done it in one of his specials.
It's that important. This is, and a lot of top professional magicians use this effect.
I know Mark Shortland uses it.
I use it.
It's a great piece of professional magic used by professionals. Professionals out there, which is why when somebody at a gig joked to me once, oh, I'll YouTube that, I'll Google it, I'll find out how it's done.
Yeah.
I was shocked. Within seconds, they had this geezer Rogue on their mobile phone and they were going, yeah, that's the one. He's on this Howlcast video and he's, clearly showing 3 million people and this guy watching it at my gig exactly how it's done. It's just
on YouTube, on an open forum.
It's too good an effect to reveal. And this is a guy that's a creator of magic, like Haunted Doll, that wants us to buy his products, but at the same time wants to destroy our livelihoods.
But no. But you explain this. This isn't the first time David said this is new. We obviously had the hats prepared because in the Wizard Product Review Studio, David was explaining this to me. He said, "Look, I'll YouTube it." And it's like 6th or 7th video down on YouTube was the one they explained. But 4th video down.
And the thumbnail is obviously there. There to show you that this is the one that you're looking for, that you've seen a magician do. This is the one that you're trying to figure
There's
out.
There's no doubt about it. When you look on there, that's the trick you just saw.
But more prominent than that, what I didn't realise, the 4th video down, it was Chris Ramsey.
Oh, I thought
the
Chris
thumbnail
was a good
again.
Chris has done some good stuff as one.
For teaching you the thumbnail. Crazy man's handcuffs again.
Quite shocked.
Absolutely shocking.
These are staples of professional working magicians.
We're out there, right? All of us performing a living, right? Not only that, both Chris and Rogue, like you said, they've got magic tricks out that they are selling to magicians. So why put that industry at risk by just opening it all out on YouTube and your own reputation? And it's just terrible. These are incredible magic tricks. You are wanted for hate crimes against magic.
Pretty strong. Let's face it, if we were to go on and make a YouTube video of something that he's doing as part of one of his professional performance videos, he'd be none too happy. Maybe he wouldn't care. Maybe he cares more about subscribers than he does about magic ethics. I don't know. Put the hats away, guys.
Back onto Medium. I look great.
Back onto Medium. This is a gimmick. It's a gimmick that you hide in your hand. When you're doing this trick where it turns over, it's got living or dead tests on there and that kind of thing, people are going to be thinking that you're using a gimmick. I was going to say the great thing about the Haunted Doll is that you can't see anything. That's the great thing about it, but I'm not giving that guy any more time on this. But with Haunted Doll, when you've performed it, people will look underneath your hand. You can't do that with Medium because you've got this gimmick that's quite clever, but it's overly clever. If Q did PK magic, this is how it was done. But it's not how a good working magician should be doing it. No. They should be finding a more commercial solution. How much are you going to give this, Wayne?
I mean, that is made well, but you know what? It's just not going to do the job. 35%.
How much are you going to give it, Sean?
Well, I don't think it's medium. I think it's poor. Definitely not average. And I am going to give this like 2%. I mean, do you know what? I'm not going to give it 2%. Really? I'm not going to give it 2%. If you buy this, nobody out there is going to buy it and do it. I'm giving it 0%.
5% from me.
Really?
Mate, the price. Think about the price, Wayne. It's 50 quid.
50
give
quid.
Give me a 50 quid and I'll give you 30% worth of magic.
Can I put my score down then? Because that...
No, you said it.
You can't edit it after the fact just based on our opinions. Yeah. Got to be
your
opinion.
I'm not going to use it.
It's straight. We're cutting the camera off. CM3, Andrew Gerard and Ran Pink's third episode in the Conscious Magic series. First of all, four different effects, one with a gimmick, all included with this very well produced DVD. We're all in agreement here that when Andrew and Ran talk about their routines, they cover them in such in-depth
discussion. I think it's for us as creators of magic, it's lovely to see other magicians who are creators taking apart what they put together. I love that process they put on tape. I think it's a great thing.
So they talk about their effects, they talk about why it works, they talk about why it connects with people, where it works.
So I think what they're saying about with these series of effects is that these aren't just your gig stuff, they're what you'd call coffee shop magic.
Yeah.
And not just coffee shop magic, really strong coffee shop magic, I think.
This is, for me, this was a DVD of two halves, but they always say if you get something off a DVD that you're really going to like and you're really going to use, then it's worth getting. Mm. And there's certainly two things I really liked, two things I wasn't that keen on. First of all was an effect called Accuracy, where Andrew has got a coin which he spins and two different bills, banknotes, and he asks one person to crumple up one banknote, keep it in their hand.
Whilst his back's turned,
yeah. Correct, there's not much of an effect otherwise. The other one they sit on or hide it out of sight, and then they spin a coin and remember whether it's heads up or tails up.
They put a coaster over the top of it so no one can tell.
Nobody can tell. And
it is brilliant.
You turn around and instantly you know all the information. You know what bill they've got where. You've got the coin, you know whether it's heads up or tails up. And there's no electronics involved.
No electronics. Brilliant. And you can do it. And what's great about it is there's no sleight of hand involved.
Yeah.
And there's no electronics involved. So you're in this situation where you're going as yourself, you're the magician. We've been playing with it just before we started filming. You're going, oh my God, it worked again.
Yeah.
You're like,
it works every time.
It's out of your control. It's not like you're doing a thing to make it work. It just works.
Everything's in the spectator's hands while you've got your back turned to them. And then when you turn back, you know everything they've done. I love it.
Because they probably take, 5 minutes to set this up, Wayne?
It took me not even that.
Less than five minutes. Wayne was on FaceTime to me last week saying, I've done it. I've got it. I've got all the bits together. It's absolutely brilliant. So we really like that routine.
And
doesn't
I've used
cost
this.
A lot of money
I,
to set
that
it up.
Routine, that one, I've done. I watched it, sat down, prepared it. Once it's prepared once, that's you're done. And so I went out. Yeah, go out, do it on people straight away. Did it, love it.
And it's a fantastic piece of magic. I love the way that Andrew performs as well. Everything seems very important, methodical, and very believable, the way he performs things. I still like his...
I was about to say that. Yeah, that's brilliant.
Out of This World from the previous series, which was on the Paul Harris box set as well, but he's got other touches on the Conscious Magic series. In fact, it's worth bringing up, you can actually buy the Conscious Magic series as a 3-volume set. So it's certainly worth getting it if you've not got any of these before, because you're going to find some great material on here. STFU is an effect where you get somebody to choose a card and they take a picture of that card. And then instantly this card vanishes from the deck. They deal through the deck themselves. And the card they remember seeing is not even the card in the photo. So you have this weird kind of effect going on where the card that they took, you took a picture of them holding, with no apps or anything like that, it just completely disappears from the deck. And whilst I mention no apps, I must mention Marty, because I did remember just there.
Yeah.
Marty is a magic app that we reviewed some time ago on the Wizard Product Review, And I was speaking to one of the creators, Oliver, quite recently. They're very excited to announce that it's coming out on Android on the 17th of July, I think it is. Hopefully, if there's no delays, it will be out on the 17th of July. So all those people that have been messaging me and messaging you saying, do you know when it's out on Android? Because we're all using it. We're always posting pictures on our walls of people holding playing cards. It is coming out on the 17th of July. What did you think to that routine with the card? You get a gimmick for this.
You do, yeah. Everything was overwritten with that first routine. This was good. I don't think I would be doing that one, if I'm honest with you, because I am so... I'm just away with it on the first one I saw.
Right, this next one was one I didn't like. It's called The Formula. Probably if I'd never seen an effect called I Hate Card Tricks, I would have liked this. But I didn't like it, mainly because I was expecting so much more. The effect is you get people to do a simple sum, and it is a very simple sum on a calculator to generate a number. And then they freely shuffle all the cards on the table by mixing them up, and they count down to the card at that number. When they count down to the card at that number, you then are able to stop, look at the card and name the card that they're just merely thinking of. But actually at the end of it, there's this really nice kicker where all the deck is blank, including the card that you've just seen. For me, that was the bit that was slightly disappointing. And I could almost, I don't know if it was just me, and far be it from me to criticise a project of Andrew's, who's a great creator, but for me, I kind of sensed a little bit of disappointment in the audience that they maybe kind of expected that card to be a real card.
Right, yeah.
And when he said at the end, it's not even the Four of Diamonds, I sensed a little bit of disappointment, or maybe it was just me.
No, I don't think it was. I agree with you.
But the problem is, I've seen I Hate Card Tricks, which is a miracle.
It's incredible.
They count down to a card. They turn over that card. It's the card they were thinking of. And then, all the decks blank. That's the kicker.
And you don't have to use a calc. I've said this to you before, and even when we were playing with...
You don't like calculator tricks.
You bring a calculator into a magic trick, I just don't like it, and I think...
Well, we were talking about a magic app that's been released.
I think it takes away from the magician. People know that they can do things with shoe size and birthdays with...
And shell oil and boobless.
You introduce a calculator, and even though in your mind as a magician, you know, you're doing something that's been a lot more well... thought out, they just go, oh yeah, I know that you can make people think of numbers with calculators, and it scares me away from doing that.
The final effect was the White Room, Rand's effect, where he gets people to change their mind from one card to another and imagine a white room, and he takes them on a journey, and at the end of it, he can kind of name, without much fishing at all, a card. Again, the problem with this for me was I've seen Russ Andrews' Destination. I've seen Russ working this in the real world, and it seems more direct. It's a very similar effect, but we all kind of agreed it seemed a bit fishy.
A little bit.
Yeah. You kind of liked it.
I liked it, but it's... I understand what you're saying.
Because he asks them questions. He says, now imagine a white room, imagine this room that's painted red, this room that's painted black, and change your mind and do this. I'm right in saying this is an odd card, it's an even card. And eventually,
he gets
to the card, and there's a little bit too much fishing compared to Destination. And because of my knowledge of these style of effects, and Russ Andrews brought Outspoken before, I think that is slightly stronger than the White Room. Although, once again, I did enjoy listening to Ran and why he was so passionate about this effect and talking about why it actually worked. And I think that is why the Conscious Magic series is such a success. It's because that you don't just get the tricks, you don't just get some great secrets like the coin effect and the bill effect, which now you're out using all the time. You get the knowledge.
You're learning.
World-renowned mentalists. You might not like everything that they do, but you're always going to learn from these two. Mm. And the project as a whole is fantastic. So whether you pick up the individual DVDs, this is Conscious Magic 3 now, or the trilogy, I don't believe you'll ever be disappointed with a purchase. No. How much are you going to give this one, Wayne?
94.
94%, you're already using something.
Yeah, 95%
I'm going to give this one exactly 89%. That's it this week for the Wizard Product Review. Don't forget to enter the caption competition. Before we go, we'll quickly mention Lads, which is coming up on the 24th of September. It's the last Sunday of September, but it's the 24th. Don't let it catch you out. It's the Ramada Jarvis, Sutton Coldfield, and we're going to announce another couple of lecturers right now. In fact, they're doing one lecture together, combining some very weird stuff that I don't really understand when they discuss it with me on the phone. They've explained it to Wayne. Wayne says he can't wait. I'm not sure.
It's going
to
be brilliant.
Tom Wright and Aaron Jones are joining forces together to present a brand new product and a lecture as well about that brand new product.
The secret of LEDs this year.
The more lecturers to be announced, John Kerry is going to be taking care of the session and jamming with John in the bar the night before, and then we've already announced Luca Volpe, and we've already talked about, to great extent, one of our star lecturers that he's not yet been announced for Lads 2017, 24th of September. Get registered right now. The room can only hold 300 people. Until next time on the Wizard Product Review, I'm Dave.
I'm Sean.
I'm Wayne.
See you next time on the Wizard Product Review.
You were yawning again at the end.
That's good.